this is really a bittersweet day. Obviously, I'm so proud of the people in this party and those of us who won and carried this banner today, but I also know that a lot of people were on that slate with us who were also extraordinary. And if you want to follow my example, and again, just try again. I worked it till I got it right. I ran three times. So do not be discouraged. Look, we talked about progress being on the ballot, and whatever happens here, we're not going back. We're not going to fall into any kinds of traps that we're going to be moving back in any direction that we've already covered. Now, we don't yet know the results of the presidential election, and I think it's going to be a very long night. But we do have a lot to celebrate just here with us. First, my incredible, abject, undying, and everlasting love for all the people on this stage. They have worked so hard and done so much. The doors knocked on, thousands and thousands, hundreds of thousands, I think, of phone calls, working for all of us to get the vote out, making it sure that everybody got our message and that we got through. And as for me, I'm extremely happy of all of them. But my heart is pretty full tonight, I have to say. But I will be, when I get to Washington this next year, we all get sworn in, the dean of the New York delegation. Thank you. It's pretty nice because we can give sort of equal weight to the subways of New York City to what we need up here in bridges and roads and airports and for our dairy farms and everybody else. But I want to welcome everybody that will be joining us in the New York delegation, Republican and Democrat, because representing the Empire State is what we do. We do it collectively, and I think we do it well. So we've got a lot to defend and everything through what we have talked about to reach out and to begin with the Empire State being in the forefront. I've got a lot of things here I need to say, and I should, but my heart is, you know, I hope you'll forgive me. I'm usually so glib that they nearly have to throw water over me to get me to stop. But tonight, I just want to say how proud I am to be a member of the Democrat Party, and what wonderful things that we stand for. Right. And for all of our lives, for all of us in this room, have benefited in so many ways from what Democrats have done before us. The Social Security, the Medicare, the Medicaid, the ACA, which is terribly important, has insured 20 million brand new people. And we hope we can keep it. We hope we can. We will try to do that. But I will tell you, whatever happens, we will keep our own resolution to stand united and to work firmly and to absolutely represent our cause to the whatever, the nth degree, whatever it takes. And I can do that because all of you stood beside me today. You brought us through. I don't suppose there was ever anything that any of us have done to equal standing today at the grave of Susan B. Anthony. The fact is, almost 100 years now since they got us the right to vote. Susan B. Anthony and Frederick Douglass working together for this. It took 70 years to do it. So many people were involved, but they never turned away. Nothing held them up. They did whatever it took, and so are we. We're going to do the very same thing because those of us in upstate New York are made from that same cloth, and we get it done. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to go back. Thank you. Thank you. I promise. Let me make a promise to you that every day while I'm there, I think about you and think about what you would want me to do. And I will be standing there as resolute as all get out, as only a Macintosh can from Harlan County, Kentucky. Boy, when you just say those words, you know there's something to tremble over, don't you? Anyway, thank you again. You are extraordinary, and I'm so happy that I have you all on my side and all these folks up here as well.
Love folks, Louise.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.